Hello, my dear students. Welcome to science class. So we are continuing with the chapter garbage in and garbage out. So let's see what we are going to learn today. So today we will be learning about what can we do to minimize the overuse of plastics and what can we do to reduce the generation of garbage. So in our previous class, we had learned about the positive and negative aspects or impact of plastic in our daily life. Okay, so regarding the negative effects, what can we do to minimize the overuse of plastics, we will be learning. Now, since the overuse of plastic articles is not good for us and the environment, so definitely we should take steps to minimize their use. So what are the uses? I'll discuss one by one. First, we should reuse the plastic carry bags for shopping purpose. Suppose you went to a market and the shopkeeper has given you the plastic bag. Okay, so instead of throwing it away, better to reuse the plastic carry bags for shopping purpose whenever it is possible to do so without any adverse effect. Okay, so this will minimize the number of plastic bags used by us, because if you again carry the same bag, the shopkeeper will not give you a new plastic bag, isn't it? So you can minimize the number of plastic bags that can be used by us. Then we should always carry our own cloth or jute bag when we go out for shopping. Okay, this will cut down on the number of plastic bags used. Next, we should use paper bags wherever possible to reduce the use of plastic bags. Okay. Next, we should reuse the plastic containers which comes with jams, pickles, oil and other packed food materials for storing salt, spices, tea leaves, sugar, etc. in the kitchen. Okay. Sometimes with the used plastic bottle, instead of crushing it and throwing it away, you can make a vertical gardening, okay, at your balcony. The next thing is what we are going to learn, that is, what can we do to reduce the generation of garbage? Okay, out of three R's, reduce. Okay, so what we can do to reduce the generation of garbage? Okay, the more garbage we generate in our day-to-day life, the more difficult it will be get rid of it. Okay, so here are some of the ways that to reduce the generation of garbage and getting rid of garbage. Number one, we should dispose our kitchen garbage by vermicomposting or composting in order to obtain high quality manure for our plants. How to do composting and how to do vermicomposting, that I have discussed in my previous video. Okay, and already you have understood that how to do this. Okay, so instead of throwing away your kitchen waste, like this, a peel of fruits and vegetables, okay, the outer peel of the fruits and vegetables and other thing, papers, eggshells, okay, what you can do, you can put it for composting or vermicomposting. This will give you what? This will give you this kind of high quality manure which you can use as a natural fertilizer for your gardening. Okay. Next, we should not throw plastic bags here and there after use. Okay. The plastic bags and other plastic containers should be reused wherever it is possible. Okay. You should never burn. And if you need to throw it, then you must always throw in a proper dustbin so that the people, they can deal with the garbage. They can put it in the landfill. Next, we should make full use of paper in our notebooks, etc. by writing on its both sides. Okay. Then, you should use what? You should use a slate pencil, slate white pencil to do rough work. If you do this, you can rub this and you can reuse it again. Okay, so that you don't have to throw papers. Okay. Next, used newspaper, magazines, notebooks, etc. They should be sent forward. They should be sent for recycling. Okay. Then, we should use cloth handkerchief instead of paper tissues to save paper and reduce the generation of garbage. Then, we should use cloth bags, jute bags and paper bags for shopping instead of plastic bags, okay, to reduce the generation of plastic garbage. Like this, here you see, this is a paper bag, this is a jute bag, okay. Always say no to paper and plastic bag, better to use cloth bag, okay. And paper bag also, if you are using, okay, that is that can be decomposed, okay, but avoid using what? Avoid using plastic bags. Okay. Then we should recycle the old and useless objects made of glass and metals instead of throwing them away. Either you can get this for recycling, or you can reuse. Okay, for the innovative purposes. Okay. And we should recycle plastics wherever it is possible. Okay. Simple ways to reduce plastic waste. What are that? Bring your own reusable shopping bag. Use a thermos at coffee shops. Okay. Instead of that paper bag. Choose paper over plastic wherever it is possible. Upcycle glass container for food storage. Buy in bulk to reduce packaging waste. Because if you buy in small packet, it will help you to generate more and more plastics. Okay. Now, garbage disposal is not only the responsibility of a government only. Okay, it is a responsibility of each one of us. Okay, all of us should take the steps to reduce the generation of garbage as much as possible. Okay, we should not throw garbage here and there. First of all, the garbage should be put in the proper dustbin so as to help in the proper disposal and to keep our surroundings clean. How you can deal with the hazardous waste? You know how you can deal with the garden waste. It has been discussed how you can deal with the waste, wet and dry waste. Okay, how you can deal with the sanitary waste. Okay, you have to deal with properly. Okay, now it is possible to reduce the problems relating to the disposal of garbage by utilizing the kitchen waste for making compost or vermicompost. Okay, by minimizing our dependence on plastic bags, by using cloth or jute paper bags, by reusing plastic container, and by recycling paper, glass and some plastic, okay, we can able to reduce the generation of garbage. Okay, so that is all about your chapter. Solid waste management, a good choice today for a healthier tomorrow. So thank you, students. Stay home, stay safe.